How little we know, how much to discover, what chemical forces flow.
From lover to lover, how little we understand, what touches off that tingle.
Well, it's not exactly fair for me to cast judgment before I even step inside, but I will say, I'm sure an establishment called Gamora is gonna be pure class. Yeah, the fact that none of the other guys wanted to join me this time round says a lot. I think Cass and Veronica were genuinely insulted I even made the suggestion. I'm seeing more red flags at the Legion camp. All I can say is keep the vomit bag on standby, I'm not taking any chances. Yeah, no shit, I'm sure that
I've been there to see Caesar die. What an asshole.
Well, sadly, I couldn't bring his head back to show anyone. There wasn't enough of it left after the chainsaw incident. But yeah, with a reputation like that, I'm not planning to stay there any longer than absolutely necessary. Oh, come on, guys, no one is manning the front desk. This is an embassy, for goodness sake. Is that lady on a bathroom break or something? Well, I'm on official business by the order of Colonel Moore herself, so unless anyone tells me otherwise, I'm just gonna wander around until I bump into the receptionist. If I stumble across any confidential shit, then it's your fault. Honestly, there wasn't even a Be Right Back sign on her desk. How can you expect Robert House, a pre-war business mogul,
Patrolling
to take the NC-
almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Hold that thought. What the hell? You're asleep? What kind of operation are we running here? A bed and breakfast?
Welcome back. What can I do for you this time?
Okay, first of all, it's 8 PM. Why are you asleep at 8 PM? And secondly, why is nobody covering for you? You're lucky I'm not your manager, because if it was up to me, you'd be sleeping in the dumpster. Anyway, Moore sent me to take care of the Omerta problem. Do you have the details or not?
Ah, excellent. I received word you may be coming. We helped the receptionist over at Gamora with some thugs that were taking advantage of her. She owes us a favor. Go talk to her. She'll be able to point you in the right direction.
Oh, lovely. So now she has the NCR taking advantage of her instead. Great. Everything is better when it's officially sanctioned. Seriously, tell Crocker to either hire someone to cover the night shift or to give you some fucking coffee. Either way, don't leave the front desk unattended like that again.
Sir?
I mean, look, I don't want to chew you out like this. I'm sure you're working ridiculous hours. But like it or not, you're the first official representative of the NCR most people around here will meet. What kind of message are you sending them if you're not even there when they walk through the door? And like I was saying, no wonder House isn't taking the NCR seriously. If someone under his employ was sleeping on the job, he would have fired them on the spot. It's cruel, but true. If my hunch is right, then this doesn't bode well for the future relationship between New Vegas and the NCR. Even if we push the Legion out for good, if one side of this diplomatic relationship fundamentally doesn't respect the other, then either nothing gets done, or there's gonna be some tension. And I'm not talking about vague threats kind of tension. I'm talking about shooting each other in the eye kind of tension. Man, that guy is still just standing out there in the open with that stupid smile on his face. How the fuck has nobody noticed yet? But as I was saying, this problem is gonna rear its ugly head soon. Just you wait. I just hope we're not around here when it happens. Okay, so here we are just outside Gamora. A quick look at the decor is telling me that subtlety will not be available in this establishment. Instead, I'm sure they'll have offerings to satisfy the entire family, am I right? And check out the uniforms. Only respectable businesses make their employees display 60% or more of their skin for the public to enjoy. Look at how proud she is. Excuse me, madam, how satisfied are you with your working conditions?
You like it, huh?
Well.
Hey there, friend. A bit of advice. You look like you could use some protection.
Steady on.
Lucky for you, I got what you need. My stock in trade? All kinds of easy to hide weapons for slipping into and out of casinos. They won't give you a second glance.
Oh, that's what you meant by protection. I was about to say, I literally just met this lady over here. I'm not that good. So what are you selling exactly? Sharpened toothpicks?
Things guards can't spot when they're patting you down or checking for iron at your hip.
Well, you say that, but I happen to know that sufficient exposure to plasma will give a man X-ray vision. So if any of those casino guards are juicing, then it won't do me any good. I'll pass, thanks.
Suit yourself. It's not my fault if they find your body dumped in Freeside.
Okay, clearly you don't know who you're talking to, so I'll let this slide for now. As for you, madam, just know that you're more likely to find his body dumped in Freeside if he keeps talking to me like that. Besides, I managed to sneak an assault rifle past casino security once with spare mags. Explain that one.
Don't be carrying any guns into the casino.
Don't worry, buddy. I knew the guy at the front desk. We were cool. Oh boy, here's another one.
You know you want a piece of this. Give me some sugar.
No offense, but something tells me this place has a no-touching rule. Either way, I'm not risking it.
Hey, no one but Omeritas are allowed to carry guns into Gamora. Check your weapons with me.
Yeah, I know the drill. Not my first time here at the casino, believe it or not. And there's a good chance I'll find something in here to use as a weapon anyway. You can kill a man with a pencil if you hate him enough.
You'll get these back on your way out.
Oh, I have no doubts that I'll get them back or this place is gonna burn to the ground. I mean, you already have multiple fireplaces in here, so you're halfway there to a blazing inferno already. All you need is a little push. Yes. So don't tempt me, motherfucker. Now then, if you'll excuse me, I need to check in with the receptionist, see if she can sell me this place better than you have so far. So yeah, I would appreciate it if you don't listen in on this conversation. Hey there, beautiful. What can you tell me about... Turn your head the other way, pal. It's not worth your life.
Hello, and welcome to Gamora. What can I help you with today?
You know what, girl? Why don't you offload your prepared marketing pitch? I don't know shit about this place, so I wouldn't know where to start anyway.
Feel free to head to our club, Brimstone, or you can see our gorgeous courtyard out behind the casino.
Brimstone? Hey, Eddie, what did I say about this place and subtlety? Yeah, sounds to me like there's too much going on here for me to experience in one night. You have any rooms available?
Sorry, we don't have any hotel rooms available right now. But feel free to gamble or help yourself to our other services.
Oh god, I don't think I've ever heard anyone say the words other services with as much forced enthusiasm as you did. Don't waste your energy hiding it, I can almost smell the vomit you just swallowed. Now, let's talk about something a bit more interesting, like juicy rumors. I bet you know all about that.
I sure do, but loose lips sink ships.
Now that sounds like genuine enthusiasm. Yeah, I bet you've been waiting all night for someone like me to listen to you gossip. Don't deny it. Well, luckily for you, I'm not into spilling my guts out to the nearest person. Normally, I spill their guts instead. What I mean is, your secrets are safe with me.
All right. You look pretty trustworthy.
Well, you're the first person to realize that. So, go on then. Give me your best. The juicier, the better.
Not much of a rumor, but I hear the Tops is always looking for new talent. Lord knows they've needed it for a long time.
Seriously? That was your best rumor? You literally just admitted it's not much of one, too. Come on, you could do better than that.
I've heard some pretty shady rumors about the Ultralux. I'm not sure what the deal is, but although they try to put on airs, that place is just plain creepy. Maybe it's the masks.
Oh, that's not even half the story. I would tell you all about it, except I made a promise not to. Plus, I don't think your soul can take it, no offense. But come on, you're just teasing me now. How about something closer to home?
I hear you've actually been inside Lucky 38. You're the first person who's been in there in as long as anybody can remember.
Not closer to my home, lady. I meant closer to yours. Why do I get the impression I'm trying to talk in code to someone who has no idea what the fuck is going on?
It's hard to believe that not too long ago, most of the families on the Strip were little more than warring tribes. The Omeritas even had a big war with the Khans once upon a time.
Okay, fuck trying to be subtle. It doesn't fit with this place anyway. I'm here on behalf of the people who saved your skinny ass. Unless you somehow forgot, you owe us a favor. Is that blunt enough for you yet?
I knew someone would call in that mark soon. What do you want to know?
Finally! God, that was like pulling teeth out of a death claw. While it's still alive. Just tell me what the bosses are planning and I'll get out of your face.
Sorry, they don't tell me their plans and I don't want to know. I'm just happy they don't make me fuck anybody anymore.
Oh, way to play the guilt trip card. I'm on a mission here, lady. It's not like I enjoy making you uncomfortable. I don't get paid for that. If you don't know the details, then point me at someone who does and I'll get the blowtorch ready.
All I can tell you is to find Cacino. He's the lowest level lieutenant you're going to be able to talk to. Some of the girls say he's been involved in some shady business the family wouldn't really like. Ask him about it.
Oh, thanks. I'm sure nothing could go wrong if I just asked the shady guy what his shady plans are. I guess private investigators have a much easier job than most people thought. Why don't we just take your suggestion and put it on the back burner for now, okay?
Bye.
I can't believe the NCR put your life in danger in exchange for this kind of juicy information. Yeah, it turns out it really wasn't worth your time listening in on that. She saved me about 10 minutes worth of digging at most. I just need a suit like yours and pretend to be new muscle.
King sold out to the NCR, huh? Might be worth a sit down with them.
Wow, you weren't listening?
Find yourself a girl or a guy. Have some fun.
Well, okay then. Looks like my luck is weirdly good so far tonight. God must be on a smoke break. Look at all these sources of open flames. This is a firefighter's nightmare and an ambulance chaser's wet dream. Oh my god. Can you handle the subtlety in this place, Eddie? Because I'm struggling. Yeah, I don't know who my parents are, but I'm pretty sure they will be shaking their heads in disappointment right now.
Gamora is always open for business.
Unfortunately so, my friend.
I hear you've been asking questions about me, dickweed. What the fuck do you want?
Wait, how? I literally went straight over here. Did your guy have a radio on him or something? Wow, I take it back. He was paying attention. I'll be sure to apologize to him later with my blowtorch. But anyway, you must be Cacino. How's your personal business going these days?
Business? What the fuck do you mean, business? You looking to get yourself burned? Now you start talking real clear, and I mean fucking crystal clear, because I'm about to lose my patience.
You're about to lose your patience? Oh, my friend, you must not know who I am, because the current whereabouts of my patience should be a primary concern. But it's okay, I'm in a forgiving mood tonight. Tell me about the rumors I've heard, and I'll pretend this didn't happen.
I don't give half a dick what you heard. Now get the fuck out of my face before I burn your sorry ass.
Okay, I admit it, that didn't go as well as I hoped.
Fiends are bad for business. NCR should do the fucking...
They're what?
I hear you've been making some waves around here.
Oh, you know who I am.
Bosses don't like no trouble in their place.
Okay, what the hell? I thought Cacino didn't know who I am. But that's clearly bullshit if the foot soldiers already do. I was willing to give him the benefit of the doubt, but clearly he's got more balls than brains. Oh, wow. That is literally a girl dancing in a cage. I didn't think we could go any lower tonight, but holy shit, color me impressed. Yeah, I don't know why, but the music in here doesn't feel appropriate for what I'm seeing. Am I in a casino right now or a Legion slave camp? I'm honestly not sure anymore. You okay up there, madam? On a scale of 1 to 10, how dignified do you feel right now? God. What happens if she needs a bathroom break? Now, see, the fact that I'm even asking that question is proof that I'm not cut out to run a casino like this. Catch the show only at Gomorrah, because no one else is tasteless enough to do something like this. I'm starting to see why the others had such a strong reaction when I mentioned coming here, especially Cass. I think she would actually start shooting the moment she walked through the door.
Those Freeside thugs aren't worth our time anymore.
And they feel exactly the same way about you, so you guys have plenty in common. Oh god, more cages. Who finds someone trapped in a small confined space sexy? I'm sure some people out there do, but I'm also sure those same people like to wear straitjackets.
Fiends are bad for business. NCR should do their fucking job.
I don't know, man. I think they would actually like this place. Ah, so this is the famous courtyard. Rex! Don't tell her to take it off. Have some decency, for goodness sake. If you're gonna act like a pervert, at least do it to a member of your own species, thank you.
Well, what do we have here, huh? Let me guess. You've heard about the mistress who makes all your fantasies come true. So you followed the call of your desires, all the way to the arms of Joanna. Moi. Now that you've found me, I wonder, do you have what it takes?
Oh boy, what a night this is turning out to be. Well, Joanna, ask not whether I have what it takes. Rather, ask whether you can handle what I have, because I don't want to be held responsible because you took on more than you can chew. Oh god, I just realized what I just said.
Oh, confident. I like that. So, what do you want to do with what you've got?
I've got this, Eddie, don't worry. Well, darling, there's an old saying that goes something like this. Show, don't tell. So why don't we both stop telling each other what we've got and get down to the showing?
Oh my, aren't you something else? I guess you'll have to see for yourself what I can do, huh? Consider it on the house, honey.
Wow, I am not used to this level of generosity, and the one time I do meet someone this generous, I cannot believe it turned out to be you. Well, I assume we're going to go somewhere more private. If I drop my pants right here, I'm gonna give new visitors a great view of my ass, and I don't know how I feel about that.
Follow me, hun.
Well, Eddie, I'll be honest with you. My first approach in this place was way too blunt and direct. As much as I joke about it, I get the feeling I really do need to be more subtle this time around. If that means I have to go with the flow, then so be it. I can hate myself later. Oh, and it goes without saying, but if you record what happens tonight and play it to the others, then I'll take up Arcade's offer and see how watertight you really are. I guess it's kind of my fault for bringing you along, but you do have a laser gun.
Evening.
Hi there. No offense, but you're dressed way too conservatively for this place. It's almost like you care about your own dignity or something. Then again, I guess I shouldn't judge so quickly. I'm willing to bet that at least half of the girls who work here is not doing it out of choice. Let's see if I'm right about that. Light the candles, Joanna. Let's get the atmosphere flowing. Oh my god. I guess this place is really not trying to disguise any intentions. Look at that! I'm no expert, but I guess the shape of the bed has a direct impact on how good the sex is. But honestly, it's just making me feel more uncomfortable.
Come here, baby. I'm all yours. Are you ready to be all mine?
Whoa, hold on there, darling. There's no rush. I'd like to know more about the person I'm gonna be in bed with. Everyone has their own unique kink, and this is mine.
All right, honey. What do you want to know?
Well, here's what I'm thinking. There must be more to the great Joanna than what I can see with my eyes. You must have some interesting stories to tell, so please indulge me on this. And let's be honest here, as far as kinks go, this one is probably quite tame compared to what you've experienced.
Oh, nothing special, hun. I'm the best lay in Gamora, and that's all you need to know.
Now you see, I'm gonna have to call you out on that. This place is filled with eye candy, so for you to stand out among all of them means that there has to be more to you beneath the skin and makeup. And no offense, but I get the feeling that you've rehearsed these lines before. So before we go too far, do you actually like what you're doing?
I like that you're here. Doesn't that make you happy?
I would be a lot happier if I believed that's how you actually feel, and boy, I sure don't. I feel like you're avoiding something. Has any of your customers ever talked to you like this before? You might not get another chance to offload. Come on, baby, show me the real Joanna, not this act.
I don't know what's happening to me. I can't feel a goddamn thing anymore. Empty and poisoned like the wasteland. I'm afraid I won't make it out of here. Not without Carlitos. If the Med-X doesn't kill me first, Cacino or another Omerta will. I look pathetic, huh? The great Joanna. And now, I don't even know why I'm telling you this.
Okay, give me a minute here. That was a lot for me to process. First off, don't call yourself pathetic, because we all have insecurities. I could go on all night telling you about mine, but I won't. Tonight is about you. So firstly, this is the second time I've heard Cacino's name being thrown around in a very disturbing context. What did he do?
He's a filthy monster. I've been with perverted men, but Cacino's done things to me that even other Omertas would also want to kill him if they knew what he does. He's broken so many of their rules that I don't know how he still breathes.
So I've heard. I'm surprised that the people who run this place even have rules to begin with. So that says a lot about Cacino. Let's get back to him later. What kind of operation is the Omerta running here anyway? I assume the casino is only part of their business.
They run the place as a center for all their dirty scams and extortions. Gambling, sex, drugs. They'll use whatever works to exploit your weaknesses. Hooker, customer, it doesn't matter. Everyone here's a pawn to the Omertas. Playing and dying by their rules.
Sounds like a lovely bunch. Then again, that's exactly what I expect based on what I've seen so far. Girls in cages, Joanna. I'm not gonna forget that anytime soon. So who are the ones in charge? When I meet them eventually, I'm definitely gonna bring that up.
Nero's the pack leader, and Big Saul's his right hand. What Nero wants, Big Saul does. Then there's Cacino.
Oh yeah, I can see you holding back tears and vomit right now. If this is too much for you, then let's not mention him again for the time being. Let's go to your happy place instead. Tell me about this Carlitos guy.
He was an Omerta that fell in love with me. They don't ever mix with people outside the family, you know? He was planning to escape with me, but Cuccino found out about us. So he did something. Talked. I don't know. And Carlitos disappeared.
Oh, shit. Well, so much for your happy place. That was definitely a misjudgment on my part. My bad. So, I guess it's against family rules to try and leave, huh?
Cuccino doesn't give a shit about rules. Only cares to feed his perversions. He lusted for me. He's done things to me. Look, I'm stuck here. I know that. Carlitos is the only thing that kept me going. And now I don't have anything left.
Well, you're only stuck here because you haven't got any outside help, and... Well, I didn't have anything else planned for tonight. Do you know what they actually did to Carlitos? He might still be around.
If he's alive, he's long gone. The Omertas want him dead now, if you meet him anywhere. I'd do anything to get him back and escape this hell. Although I'm not keeping my hopes up.
Ah, well, you only think it's hopeless because you haven't heard of me. That's a trend I'm starting to notice tonight, but I won't hold it against you. Look, I could do some digging to see if Carlitos is still around, but with or without him, I need to get you the fuck out of here.
Hun, nobody's given me a free thing before. What's it going to be for you? Caps? Sex? Straps? What?
Well, first of all, I don't sleep with other men's women, and you clearly consider yourself Carlito's woman now. Secondly, you're gonna need every cap you have once you get out of here, so what kind of prick would I be if I took away your livelihood? So, unless you could think of something else to give me, I guess I'm gonna have to break the trend and give you this for free.
What? Are you serious? Well, I'm not complaining, hun. Thanks so much for your help.
Yeah, thank me after I get you out. And can I tell you something about me for a moment? My real kink isn't to find out more about people. I'm not sure what my kink is, but I'm starting to think it's to help people in crisis. Yeah, you heard that right. Keep a low profile until I get back. If anyone asks, tell them I'm getting more drinks. Did I surprise you, Eddie? I surprised myself too, if I'm honest. I know, I keep going on about getting paid and doing things for free, but I'm starting to think that maybe it's just an excuse. I mean, I have a lot of money now, and I can easily make more. Yet, I still want to do shit like this. Maybe it's just this place. The level of exploitation that goes on here is just overwhelming. Doing something for free is basically giving the Omertas the finger. And if I take away their star attraction tonight, then it's the biggest finger I could give them. For now, anyway. What? Corporal White? Oh, wait a minute. Isn't that someone Boyd wanted us to find? Man, this is one of the reasons I keep you around all the time. That guy'd like to visit a hooker in this casino. I completely forgot. Oh shit, that means I'm gonna have to talk to every girl here. This awkwardness is never gonna end, is it? Hello.
Hey there, sugar. I'm Dazzle. What can I do for you? Or to you? You're so handsome, I might just give you a discount.
Wow, apparently I have something these girls really want. Probably an escape plan. So what's your story? Am I gonna have to help you out too?
Well now, that's unusual. Normally no one cares enough to ask. To be honest, I don't rightly know. My mama was from around these parts. I can remember her face, but not her name. More than I can remember of my daddy, I guess. We lived in Westside before the Omertas bought me. As bad as it can be some days in here, it's better than living in that dump.
Oh, so I guess you're okay with your current arrangements, huh? Yeah, I guess in order to consider an escape, you would either have to get it particularly bad here, or you're the type who values freedoms and dignity more than physical comforts. So, any chance you've heard of someone called White?
Yeah, he used to come around here a lot. Haven't seen him in a while, though. Why?
Well, he's missing. Likely dead. Actually, I'm not a gambling man, but I think we can safely scratch off the word likely. Any chance he told you anything the last time he was here?
He used to go on and on about water and the farms east of the Strip. He was talking to one of the farmers named Bascom. Had some problem with NCR. Boring as hell, but it was his money and his time. So I let him talk about whatever.
Wow, you just gave me a name, a place, and a potential lead. Yeah, I'm gonna say you've been more helpful than the receptionist. So, I hate to leave it at that, girl, but I have prior commitments tonight. Don't ask me what it is. I have a feeling you'll hear all about it tomorrow morning.
Don't be a stranger.
Oh, I'm not gonna be. Chances are in the next few hours, I'm either gonna get mentioned on the radio, or my face is gonna be on a wanted poster. Or indeed both.